the Order of the Quest, Freemasonry, the Ancient Order of the Rose and Cross, the Knights Templar, the Sovereign and Military Order of the Knights of Malta, the Order of St. John of Jerusalem, the Priory de Sion, the Thule Society, or sometimes known as the Thule Society, the Order, the Skull and Bones, the Russell Trust, the Jason Society, the Scroll and Key, the Illuminati, and I could go on and on and on and on. But the most important thing to realize is that they all have been collectively known throughout the ages as the Mystery Schools, the Illuminati, which literally means illumined ones. They are all one and the same, as you will come to know. And you will understand perfectly how they've been able to infiltrate all of our society. What you hear tonight does not necessarily reflect my views, our beliefs, our religion. They have ruled from the shadows, you see. And they call themselves the guardians of the secrets of the ages. And their first religion was called astrotheology, or the worship of the heavens. And their first object of worship was the sun. The second object of worship was the moon. And everywhere you see the mystery schools or the mystery religion, you will see the symbols of the sun and the moon, also known as Osiris and Isis. For in the religion of the mystery schools, they believed that man was held prisoner in the Garden of Eden by an unjust and vindictive God. And that man was not told by this unjust and vindictive God that he could have the same powers. And man was set free from the bonds of ignorance by Lucifer through his agent Satan, and many believe that the two are the same. That's okay, because maybe they are. And that through the gift of intellect, man himself will become God. Now, for those of you who understand what I am imparting to you now, you may not even have to listen any farther, for it explains everything that has ever happened in the history of man, and everything that is happening now, and all that is to happen in the future. They believe that the tree-dwelling ancestors of man were among the most intelligent beings of their distant age. And when these creatures finally abandoned the trees and walked fully upright, freeing their hands to serve as implements of their minds as well as their bodies, there began the most successful evolutionary drive toward higher intelligence ever witnessed in nature. And that whoever these people are, who are the priests, the adepts, and the initiates of the mystery schools, they are in control, and they are shaping the future, and that future will affect all of us, so we had better learn as much about them as we can. democracy is ruled by the mob, the mob always votes themselves every kind of benefit that they can vote themselves. And whenever you do that, it means large, tremendously overpowering government with control.
They vote themselves into dependency.
That's it. They vote themselves into a dictatorship is what they do, where they lose all of the benefits that they intended to vote themselves into in the first place.
Okay.
And democracies are extremely dangerous to minorities, because if the majority of people don't like you,
right. They're
going to vote that they kill you, and they can, you know, that's it. Democracies are dangerous. Democracies are socialists. Democracies are communism. That's what communism is. The definition of communism is everybody doing according to their talents and receiving according to their need. And it doesn't work. We already know it doesn't work. Men, by his inherent nature, is greedy.
Mm-hmm.
So those at the top always end up having everything, and those at the bottom end up having nothing in communism. Socialism is different. Socialism usually ends up in a dictatorship, in a very controlling dictatorial government, which even owns the people that it governs, so that those who live in fear of not having are provided for what they need, and in turn, they worship this oppressive government. Socialists are children who went out into the world, took a look around and said, I can't handle it, and went home to daddy.
Okay.
Daddy, protect me. Daddy, feed me. Daddy, loan me your car. Daddy, tuck me in at night. Socialists are scared little children who are irresponsible, can't stand on their own two feet, and need daddy to take care of them.
Okay.
Okay?
Now we got the...
But what happens when you go home to daddy and daddy does all these things for you? Tell me.
Well, you never leave the home. You've not got no reason to. In other words, if you're being provided for in that way.
You're being provided for, but what does it mean? Doesn't it mean that you have to do what daddy tells you to do?
True.
Doesn't it mean you have to be in when daddy tells you to be in? Doesn't it mean that you can't drive the car to the next town if daddy tells you you can't? Doesn't it mean that if daddy tells you to take out the trash, you better take out the trash? Are you beginning to understand the concept? Mm-hmm. When you ask for favors from daddy, you have to give up freedom in return.
Right. Okay.
So socialism always leads to repression of liberty, freedom, equality. All of those things fly out the window, so that you can have free health care, so that you can have a place to live, but you don't have to pay the rent, so that you can have food given to you by the state. And that's where we're headed.
You know, we laugh at sheep because sheep just follow the one in front. Oh, stupid sheep. We humans have out-sheep the sheep, because at least the sheep need a sheepdog to keep them in line. Humans keep each other in line. And they do it by ridiculing or condemning anyone who commits the crime, because that's what it's become, of being different.